Hi everyone, this is Lahiri from ABCs of Anesthesia, and right now I'm going to be demonstrating the front of neck access or surgical airways. Now, this is in the context of your difficult airway algorithm. So for example, whatever algorithm you're using, whether it's the difficult airway society or the vortex approach, you're going to be trying all the different methods of supraglottic airway access. For example, you might be trying to bag, mask and optimize that, use an LMA or intubate with laryngoscopy, and maybe even try a video laryngoscope. Now, if all of these things are failing, that's when you need to start preparing for a surgical airway, and so that's what we're going to go through. So let's get started. So this next technique in the algorithm is, say you fail the needle crack technique or you've chosen to do a surgical technique. Andrew Heard's algorithm describes the scalpel bougie technique. Now, I really like this technique just for its simplicity. You essentially just need three pieces of equipment, really. So that's your scalpel, your bougie, and then a size 6 tube. So again, with this technique, I'm standing on the left side of the patient because I'm right hand dominant. I'm doing that laryngeal handshake, finding out where that cricoid cartilage is and the thyroid prominence, and that's your cricothyroid membrane. I'm doing that hold of the larynx with my thumb and forefinger, and then I'm using my scalpel and doing a horizontal incision on the cricothyroid membrane, just like so. And now at that point, I can point the scalpel down and turn it vertically. You can see that there's a bit of a triangle created, and that's where my bougie is going to slide. So I then swap my hands, pass the bougie along the surface of the blade, and once I'm in the trachea, I can turn it caudal down towards the lungs and push the bougie through. Now, I'm mindful not to push the bougie through too far, because I really don't want to cause any trauma down into the airway. I remove my scalpel and put that safely. And usually this is a two-person technique. You know, you want to be able to stabilize the bougie and then also pass a size 6 tube. And at this point, I can railroad this tube down. So that's heading down. This is, again, a variation of the cell digger technique that we'll often use for line insertions. And I give a small rotation. And then I really just need to push it down to the black line, just like in a normal intubation. That way the cuff is in the trachea. I then take the bougie out. Once I've taken the bougie out, inflate the cuff. Sometimes you might need more than 5 mils. Just want to make sure there's no leak there. And then connect my Liddell bag. And you can see ventilation there. Of course, I can attach my filter and my entitled CO2 measurement device to make sure that I'm actually in the lungs. Now, once I'm in the airway with the bougie, the technique describes using a RapiFit connector, and this way I can use this connector, insert it onto the end of my bougie and clasp it on with this white locking device. So now that's really firmly fit there. This then connects to one of those 15-22 millimeter connectors, which is the standard type connector. And that way I can get some oxygenation in. Now, while this will give you oxygenation faster, using this connector may be a bit slower just because I can't get the same level of pressure. Sometimes these RapiFit connectors have a lure lock, which means I could connect a jet ventilation device to get rapid oxygenation. Sometimes you may not have a RapiFit connector, in which case you can just use your 14-gauge cannula, insert it like so, and then attach your rapid oxygenation device. And this may provide some level of oxygenation through a jet ventilation device, even though I didn't have the proper RapiFit connector, which would sit there. Now, even though that this is the technique that's taught by the Andrew Heard algorithm, I know that in some situations we might not have a RapiFit device and I might not have all my equipment ready for rapid oxygenation once I've got the bougie in. And maybe my bougie doesn't have a hole. They're not always going to be this way. Therefore, I may just want to railroad that size 6 tube as quickly as possible to get my patient safe with a definitive airway. I'm now going to show this in one smooth sequence. So laryngeal handshake, making a vertical incision, opening up that triangle, swapping hands, loading the bougie along the blade towards the airway. I can either confirm with the I can use the RapiFit connector or just connect my tube straight off and then railroad my tube, take my bougie out, inflate the cuff, and then put that on. So thanks so much for watching this series of videos. I hope they were really useful to you. Please share with anyone who might be interested, and I'll see you next time for the next video.